Day Outlook.
Trouble. Bettis left the keys around again, which means you're stuck with me on a Friday night. Bettis, not around, but I am. Hello and welcome to Weather Underground. I'm Mark Elliott. Bettis has the night off, so let's get right on into it. Here's what's on tap tonight. A soaked South Florida, a stormy Pacific Northwest, and your football forecast. And man, that's a good one. First, though, the soaked South Florida. 2 days straight of record rain, and it's still falling. We'll tell you how many more inches they could see before it's all said and done. Also, stormy Pacific Northwest. A destructive storm is bringing heavy rain, snow, and winds. Millions of people could lose power. Will they get the lights back on before the next big storm comes charging on through? Also, your football forecast. It is a huge weekend of college football. We've got everything you need to know before you head out to the big tailgate party. Man, a lot to cover today here on Weather Underground, but let's start out in the South. Heavy rain and records continue to fall in South Florida. At 6 a.m. this morning, Miami had already set a daily rainfall record. Flood threat stretches into tomorrow. Let's talk about this setup for the rain here across the South, right? Cold front has made it through much of the Southeast. That's all the dry air that's in play. You can feel that on your hands and your lips across the Southeast. It is dry, but that front did not get all the way through South Florida. Let's take a look at some of the radar that we've got going on because, man, it is really coming down still across portions of South Florida. Miami getting a bit of a break, but Fort Lauderdale about to get another round. In fact, if you're traveling 75 right across Florida, whew, it is a tough ride right now. As for what happens from here, we can actually use our high-resolution models and show you what happens through the next several hours. And this might be a little bit overdone. You saw some of the extra rain nearby on the beginning of that model run. But it does give you the flavor. It lets you know that we're not quite done here. All the way into Saturday morning, there's still going to be some showers and some storms nearby South Florida. So we can continue to that's looping back to where we were. So let's just take the Weather Channel forecast. Over the next 24 hours, what we expect to see here, several more inches of rain. In fact, we can click into some of these. How about this? Outside the Miami area, this is saying, it's up here. 2 to 3 inches of rain, if not 3 to 5 inches of rain, right in here. We'll zoom in for you, right into the Miami metro. Yeah, you're in the dark green and the yellow. So 2 to 3, if not 3 to 5 additional inches of rain, which is pretty substantial considering where we've been already today. We can also show you where we've been already today. How about the past 24 hours here in South Florida? Man, it has really been coming down. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. We can show you that around Miami, estimates of 3 inches there. In fact, we can show you exactly how much there's been in and around the Miami area. Here is the 3-day rainfall total, over 5.34 inches of rain. Your average winter rainfall, the entire winter season, 5.9. We've almost gotten there in just 3 days. It's been coming down in cats and dogs. And one more thing to show you here. In Miami, the average for the year is 60.08. So far, 54.06. So we actually have a bit of rain yet still to go if we're gonna get to that yearly average. Now, this time of year, we're usually talking about some snow, but the snow map, oh, it's been really quiet for that first week of December, right? What's happening here? Not much. There is not much happening across the lower 48 right now. In fact, if you're going to find any snow, you got to go into the Pacific Northwest, and even that has been reasonably low. In fact, we've been talking about El Nino contributing to this. Are we blaming this lack of snow on El Nino too? Winter weather expert Tom Nizzle is here. And Tom, this is a very different pattern from where we were the past couple of seasons.
Oh, absolutely. You know, you remember last season, the whole Northeast really went into an Arctic ice box as we went through the winter. And this year, we're not seeing that. It all has to do with the jet stream.
Yeah.
By the way, Mark, I was looking at this today out in the Pacific. We've got a jet stream, 200 mile an hour jet that is banging into the west coast of the U.S. And you can see that this jet stream is working more from a west to east pattern, what we refer to as a zonal type of weather.
You're not getting those big buckles in the jet, allowing that jet stream to go all the way down to the Gulf Coast because it's too strong still across the north. The 200 mile per hour winds, I mean, there's just no wiggle room there.
Well, that's it. And the northern stream has been displaced very far north. We have an active southern stream, but because it's displaced so far north, take a look at the temperature departures here. We're running 15 to 20 degrees above normal in some cases.
It's hard to get snow when portions of North Dakota are near 50 degrees.
Yeah.
I mean, the ice box of the nation is near 50.
International Falls, you know, they'll be up near 50 degrees, not at this time of the year typically.
Right. I mean, that is really different. I mean, that's noticeably different.
Yeah, and you know, if we take a look at the forecast for the entire month of December, it's very what we would refer to as El Nino-like, of course. You're the only cold weather going to be down in the southern U.S., I should say below normal temperatures, not necessarily cold. And a lot of that may have to do with just the storminess across there, keeping the daytime highs relatively low. But take a look at the upper Midwest, the Great Lakes region, the Northeast, that entire area over the entire month now is expected to be above normal. That doesn't mean we can't get a few cold outbreaks into there to produce some snow.
Do you think that's saying more of a lack of storminess, a lack of precipitation, or is it just the temperatures and the more sunshine adding to the mix?
It's just the temperatures. It's just that pattern of keeping the cold air locked up far north in Canada. If you take a look, if we go into the next week here, look at the departures, how much warmer it is going into southern and central Canada. That's where a lot of our cold air typically comes from. And then if we go into the week after that, we now see the cold or the warm air really locked into the east, but there are changes. The west now begins to get cold as some of this energy out of the Gulf of Alaska comes down. It's going to turn on for snow across the western U.S. If you're looking toward the holidays, the Christmas holidays, and you want to book somewhere to go skiing, you know where. Go west, young man.
And so the lower 48, not much snow. We're going to talk about another thing that gets rid of some of that snowfall. We have a lot more to talk about with regards to the lack of snow here. Do you ever notice snow disappearing even on days that stay below freezing? Is someone stealing your snowflakes? Well, Tom and I are going to investigate the case of the vanishing snow using this dry ice. We're going to be heading up to the lab to show you the science of sublimation. That's coming up next. And also coming up, storm after storm has been pounding the Northwest. Reports of wind gusts over 100 miles an hour. Find out what major areas could see major power outages before too much longer. Plus, our planet is getting warmer, and just a few degrees makes an enormous impact. We'll show you how 1 or 2 degrees Celsius literally makes a world of difference.
Want to be the house that all the neighbors stop by to admire? Then stop by Ace. We'll help you find the right lights, cords, and decorations to make your house shine. Come in now and choose from a variety of long-lasting, energy-saving LED lights for just $15.99 each.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Meet the lumberjack whose flannel was out of whack. Freedom to move is what he lacked. Even when woodland creatures attack. Until they put Duluth Free Swing and Flannel on his back. With armpit gussets to whack and hack. Now he's known as a lumberjack. Duluth Trading Free Swing and Flannel. Swinging made easy. Flannel made burly. Get it. Only at DuluthTrading.com.
Look at you, saving money on your Medicare Part D prescriptions. At Walgreens, we call that Carpe Med Diem. That's almost Latin for seize the day to get more out of life and Medicare Part D. From $1 copays on select plans to now reward points on all prescriptions, Walgreens has you covered. So drop by and seize the savings. Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy.
The holidays bring many challenges to the feet. By day, they must stay warm, but by night, beautiful, smoother, and ready to impress the other party animals. Dr. Schultz, DreamWalk Express Petty.
Discover Card.
Hi. So it says here I can redeem my cashback bonus for cash. Do I need to have a certain amount?
Nope.
You can redeem your cashback for any amount, anytime.
That's great.
Yeah,
you can use it for a statement credit or even get the cash.
Nice.
I could use that extra cash for a last-minute gift.
One less thing hanging over your head.
Right.
Tell me about it. Gary, you gotta go.
Who's Gary?
Mistake from last year,
coming back around again.
Too much eggnog.
Yes,
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Redeem your cash back for any amount, anytime. Get it at discover.com.
With Crizal No Glare lenses, neither scratch, nor smudge, nor glare of night can keep you from the clearest vision possible. Plus, Crizal gives you the most comprehensive UV protection. Crizal No Glare lenses. Live life in the clear.
During the holidays, we have a family tradition of staying in our pajamas, and we do all our gift shopping at Burlington. I think these are perfect. This is a good price.
Merry Christmas!
Oh, man. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Harry. Man.
You gotta do it like this. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, George.
Hey, Jim.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
Yes, we are twins. When I went on to Ancestry, I just put in the name of my parents and my grandparents. And I was getting all these leaves, and I was going back generation after generation. You start to see documents, and you see signatures of people that you've never met. I mean, you don't know these people, but you feel like you do. You get connected to them. I wish that I could get into a time machine and go back 100 years, 200 years, and just meet these people. Being on Ancestry, it just made me feel like I belonged somewhere.
Discover your story. Start searching for free now at Ancestry.com.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
A lot of people traveling, but we'll keep an eye on it for you.
So include us in your routine.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Welcome back, everybody. Thanks for sticking around with Weather Underground. And check this out, a beautiful sunset in the time lapse of the snow there, captured in southwest Minnesota. Beautiful, look at that shining on the snow, right? That's after Winter Storm Delphi. You might not be able to tell, but some of that snow is actually disappearing, despite the fact that it's really cold out. It's not by melting, and we're gonna get to that in just a minute, showing you how that snow can disappear. In the lab, our winter weather expert Tom Nizzle is here. And Tom, we're going to take a look at where the snowpack has been and how some of that snow has been kind of evaporating, but not right in front of our eyes.
It's an interesting process. So we're going to start with a satellite image from our polar orbiter, low orbit satellite, showing the beautiful picture of the snow cover. Yeah. This is the other day across the central plains from what Delphi had put down. And you can see the edges of the snow here, the river valleys and that, but we're losing some of that snow. So if we move this forward in time, this is a loop from the other day, and right there is a snow cover. You can see that clouds moving across here, but the snow is actually melting as we go forward in time with this loop.
Yeah, and it's contracting just a little bit, right? You can see it starts here and ends closer to there.
Now, on the edges, a lot of this area, the temperature went above freezing the other day.
Okay.
But in some areas, like Sioux City, the temperature never even made it above the freezing mark. They only got to 28 degrees, yet they lost snow as well.
So their snow depth went down, even though we didn't see bare ground, but some of the snow did disappear.
It did. Now, some of it compacted, but some disappears from the top. How in the world do you lose snow if the temperature is below the freezing mark?
I have a feeling you're going to show us right now.
Ah, yes, and it's such a sublime process.
I see what you did there.
That to Ryan. Ryan is the author of that. So it has to do with something called sublimation. And sublimation is essentially the change of state from a solid to a gas. We skipped the liquid there.
Okay.
And that's what was happening in this state. So, on a typical day, the air temperature warms well above the freezing mark. The sun is coming down, it's hitting the snow, and what are we going to get there?
You'd get a puddle, it's melting away, you'd get liquid water.
Yeah, but if the temperature stays below freezing, as it does in a lot of places, and it did in Sioux Falls, or Sioux City, I should say, that sun is still coming down, it's beating on that snow surface. It excites a lot of the molecules right at the surface there, and as those molecules are excited, they actually go into a vapor state, a gaseous state, into the atmosphere.
So the sun gives enough energy that it would have melted the snow, and then that melted water would have turned into a gas. But because it's so cold, it can't go through that in-between step. So it has to just go right to the gas.
So it goes right to gas. And so that's the process there. But we can have a lot of fun with this.
Let's see this in another way.
Yeah, we're going to deal with carbon dioxide in its solid state. And what is carbon dioxide in its solid state?
We've got the dry ice right here.
Dry ice right here. And so what happens with dry ice is even at very low temperatures, it never goes through a liquid state. It's all sublimation. So we don't see any water around this, do we?
We're in the lab, but not a lab that could get liquid water out of carbon.
Not in this lab. Yeah. It doesn't get cold enough in here. Although some people think so sometimes, but no. So what we're ending up here is you can see that what is leaving the ice right now is in the form of the gas, and I'm kind of keeping my hands here. Maybe I'll put my dark gloves behind us so we can see that coming off of there. And that is the same process, essentially, that we're going through with snow as it sublimates into its gaseous state, into water vapor, when the temperature is below freezing.
So no way to see liquid carbon dioxide here, but you do see it going solid to gas.
Yeah, that's our Meteorology 101 on sublimation.
Yeah, so if you have a question about sublimation, we want to hear from you. You can use the hashtag WUTV, and our team of experts will answer them live right here on the show. Plus, we're counting down the best videos of the entire week, and that includes what happens right here.
It'll be good.
Look at that, right? Find out what this driver caught on camera that ended up being a really close call. That is part of our video six pack later this hour, and you don't want to miss it, that's for sure.
It'll be good.
Don't touch that stuff.
Feeling cold? Try Hot Hands. Simply open the package and they heat up quickly. Quick, long-lasting warmth. Go get your own. Hot Hands. Bring the heat.
We always come to Burlington to buy our coats.
And we also come to give them back.
To help those in need. Can't beat the brands, the styles.
And when we donate a coat at Burlington,
we get 10% off our entire purchase.
It makes buying coats here even more meaningful.
Bring in your coats!
Awake! Intel's best processor is here, and it helps PCs wake up instantly, just like you did.
That's great, but do you mind?
No, I don't mind.
Introducing Intel's new 6th generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
Want to be the house that all the neighbors stop by to admire? Then stop by Ace. We'll help you find the right lights, cords, and decorations to make your house shine. Come in now and choose from a variety of long-lasting, energy-saving LED lights for just $15.99 each.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Isn't it funny that the people you're closest to are also the hardest to shop for? But if you know where to look for inspiration, you can find the perfect gift for everyone on your list. Low prices on everything you need to share wonder every day. Walmart.
Hi, I'm Heather Cox, on location with the famous Big Idaho Potato Truck.
Our truck?
It's touring across America telling people about Idaho potatoes.
Let's go, boys!
Again this year, the Big Idaho Potato Truck is traveling the country, spreading the word about heart-healthy Idaho potatoes and making donations to local charities.
Excuse me, miss. Have you seen our truck?
You just missed it.
Man, are you kidding me?
Mondays at 10, the Weather Channel drops you into a new season of nature's worst-case scenarios and asks, so you think you'd survive?
It's coming toward us!
The hit original series is back to put your survival skills to the test.
Could be the last mistake you make.
Oh, my God!
So you think you'd survive? All new Mondays at 10.
If you want a great lawn, you can spend hours every week mowing, weeding, fertilizing, or experience a greener world with Synthetic Turf International. Spend time enjoying your lawn, not working on it. Experience a greener world with Synthetic Turf International.
Here we go.
It's our biggest December ever, starting with season premieres of Prospectors at 9 and Highway Through Hell at 10.
Bam!
Sunday on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees with light rain. Tonight, cloudy with periods of rain, low 70. Rainfall around a half an inch. Saturday, cloudy with occasional rain showers, high 79. Chance of rain, 80%. Saturday night, variable clouds with showers and scattered thunderstorms, low 74. Here's our 7-day outlook.
It's amazing out there, and we've got the stunning weather photos from you guys to prove it every single day. This is an awesome shot. Believe it or not, this is the moon there. A long exposure shot sent in by Jason in Buchanan, Virginia. Jason, this is an amazing picture. Number one, I think it potentially is taken out of a fisheye lens, so you've got that great curve. It makes you feel like you're on the round Earth. But notice this. Look at that. You got the halo around the moon, and that's there because of these high clouds, some high cirrus clouds, some ice in the atmosphere up above. So the light from the sun reflecting off the moon then gives you that halo that you can see in this shot, which is pretty awesome. Occasionally, you can even see these around on a real cold night around your street lamps because they've put out enough light to give you a halo around them. So really cool stuff, a great shot here. You can see some of the stars off in the background, some of those high clouds in the distance, and then that great curve from the fisheye lens. So, really appreciate this one. We always want you guys to send in your photos. If you have any amazing weather shots, you can post them onto weather.com or onto the Facebook page of either the Weather Channel or Weather Underground, and we'll get them there as well. But we also do another segment. It's called Picture This. We've got some cool features in this shot, and not just the McDonald's or the Wendy's, right? Stick around to hear what I spotted in this awesome sunset photo that was posted earlier today. It's time now for you guys to sound off. Our social meteorologist, Ryan Davidson, has been hard at work behind the bar, combing through your questions. And Ryan, there's been several coming in. What's the first one?
It is all a buzz. Everyone's on Twitter about dry ice.
Why wouldn't
really?
They be? It's fun.
It is. First question, however, was a little bit ago, and it was from Donna.
All right, Donna says, hi, Mike, or Mark, as the case may be. Is it verified yet that around Christmas the pattern will change and the Midwest will see cold and very snowy conditions?
That looks like someone who's looking for snow.
A little wish casting.
And I would too. Well, I'll tell you what, as we go further into the pattern, into the latter part of December, there's a suggestion that there's going to be an undercut of cold air coming in out of the Pacific, first into the western U.S. and then across the southern U.S. So the dividing line is going to be right across the Midwest. Mm. So it's still up in the air, but it's not out of the question that we could begin to see that change to colder conditions by Christmas time up through about the Mississippi River.
And we were talking about this earlier, even more of a potential for after the new year and as winter goes on for maybe the Midwest and the Northeast to get in on at least a couple cold bursts.
Yeah, and again, we're looking at that. There are some researchers, some models that are suggesting there may be a little bit of a switch being flipped as we get in after the first of the year, that maybe the Northeast may begin to come under some colder weather. Mm-hmm. I still treat that with a little more than a flip of a coin,
sure.
So we've got to get a little
too
closer
early
to
tell
it.
But we got to watch it. I mean,
that's
lots
right.
of people are watching that.
Yep.
One more questions are coming in. Let's go to the next one here for you guys sounding off. And Jared Liu says, how does freezing fog form?
Oh, wow. Hey, that's a good question. That's an interesting one. So fog, super cool droplets are really, really tiny. Even when the temperature is below 32 degrees, there's still little droplets. Freezing fog, the surface is below 32. So those little droplets can actually impinge upon the surface and they freeze the surface up. This is very dangerous for black ice type conditions.
Yeah.
And it can produce rhyming on trees and branches. That can be beautiful.
Works the same way as freezing rain. It's just in a fog. And
in
finally,
fog.
We got one more for you. You guys have been sounding off, and this one comes from Sal. In sublimation, how come this doesn't seem to apply to the Arctic and the Antarctic regions, or does it, but it's not noticed?
Oh, it does. In fact, it's very, very common up in those parts of the world.
It's probably the only way that the ice moves around during the wintertime.
That's correct, yeah.
So, great question there. And we want you guys to keep sending in your questions. Use the hashtag WUTV, and we'll try to answer them live right here on the show. Coming up still, the Pacific Northwest just can't catch a break. They are bracing for another round of rain, snow, and really damaging wind gusts. We're going to show you how much snow and rain will fall before it's all over. And man, the power outage issues might become the big story out of this one. The wind, even off the coast, as Tom, you were talking about.
Yeah, another big event here. Not as big as last week and a half or so, but there's going to be more wind.
Something to watch. We'll give you the details coming up right after this.
We experienced our first Northeast winter.
We were freezing.
So we went to Burlington. There's so many brands to choose from.
That looks good on you.
We found something for everybody. And the prices are great. This year, we're prepared.
Yes!
Lowe's presents How to Be Good at Math.
How much money do you think we saved today?
A lot.
Come into Lowe's today for great deals, like this Porter Cable compressor for only $99.
I use what's already inside me to reach my goals. So I like when my doctor told me I may reach my blood sugar and A1C goals by activating what's within me. With once weekly Trulicity. Trulicity is not insulin. It helps activate my body to do what it's supposed to do, release its own insulin. Trulicity responds when my blood sugar rises. I take it once a week, and it works 24/7. It comes in an easy-to-use pen. And I may even lose a little weight.
Trulicity is a once-weekly injectable prescription medicine to improve blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes. It should be used along with diet and exercise. Trulicity is not recommended as the first medicine to treat diabetes and should not be used by people with severe stomach or intestinal problems or people with type 1 diabetes or diabetic ketoacidosis. Trulicity is not insulin and has not been studied with long-acting insulin. Do not take Trulicity if you or anyone in your family has had medullary thyroid cancer or multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2 or if you're allergic to Trulicity or its ingredients. Stop using Trulicity and call your doctor right away if you have symptoms of an allergic reaction such as itching, rash, or difficulty breathing. If you have signs of pancreatitis, such as severe stomach pain that will not go away and may move to your back with or without vomiting. Or if you have symptoms of thyroid cancer, which may include a lump or swelling in your neck, hoarseness, trouble swallowing, or shortness of breath. Medicines like Trulicity may cause stomach problems, which could be severe. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and any medicines you take. Taking Trulicity with a sulfonylurea or insulin may increase your risk for low blood sugar. Common side effects include nausea, diarrhea, vomiting, decreased appetite, and indigestion. Some side effects can lead to dehydration, which may cause kidney failure.
With Trulicity, I click to activate what's within me.
If you want help improving your A1C and blood sugar numbers with a non-insulin option, ask your doctor about once-weekly Trulicity and click to activate your within.
Happy, happy, happy for you and me. Happy, happy, happy for you.
Intel's best processor is here, which gives new PCs 3 times the battery life, so you never have to stop watching.
Thanks!
Introducing Intel's new 6th generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
Hey, buddy. You hungry?
Make your best friend's holiday season extra special at PetSmart. Spend $35 and get a $5 holiday bonus bucks coupon.
When I lay in my Tempur-Pedic contour, the next thing I know, it's morning.
With Tempur-Flex, you've got the spring and bounce of a traditional mattress. Then it also adjusts my body.
My cloud feels like somebody's hugging you. How can a bed do that?
There's a Tempur-Pedic for everyone.
I love you.
Love you too.
1 minute.
Letting go. It's a little easier when you've saved for college with State Farm.
I'm Mike Bettis. That's Sarah. Hi. Welcome to the set of a brand new show, Weather Underground. There'll be experts, bloggers, the smartest weather minds in the business on every screen you have 24 hours a day. Geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Closed captioning brought to you by Maglite Flashlights.
Today we're getting record snowfall.
Radars indicate there's been flooding throughout the area.
We're getting hail the size of golf balls.
Maglite. Turn your light on, America.
And then the thunder. Man, the thunder. Lightning strike was pretty good, but the thunder was the impressive part of that one.
Keith and I were talking. This looks like it's somebody's apartment building. Yeah. And if you were taking a nice midday nap that one, you are now.
What I think surprised me the most is that all those lights stay on. I expect like that whole building to go dark because that was such a great lightning strike. But
yeah, your alarm system starts to go off. I mean,
camera even shakes.
Yeah.
A little bit scared from the noise.
Wow.
My goodness. So, Alex joining us here in the cave. Alex, any thunderstorms on the horizon in the next couple days?
For South Florida, yes.
Let's do it.
Let's take a look at your current weather. Across a lot of the southeast, most of Florida, notice there's not much happening. Well to the south of Jacksonville, a few showers, but all the action is and will be into parts of South Florida, down around Miami, around Naples, Tampa, Fort Lauderdale. These are places that have been soggy and will stay soggy through the weekend. Notice from Everglades City off towards Boca Raton, we've got some heavier showers embedded in there, but at least light to moderate rain. One side of the state to the other. And the reason is we've got a stalled frontal boundary that's just going to hang out over the weekend. Tropical moisture in play, going to keep things really soggy. There is that tropical moisture. And again, a frontal boundary just really serves as a focusing mechanism for shower, thunderstorm development. So with it hanging out there over South Florida over the next few days, showers, thunderstorms, locally heavy rain, some flash flooding would be possible as well. Tomorrow, showers and storms. Tomorrow, showers and storms. And I bet you can't guess what's headed your way Monday. Wait for it. Showers and storms! I know. My job's really difficult tonight. I really should have just, you know, let anybody do it. We've got 3 to 5 inches of rainfall, though, coming to parts of eastern Florida, right around north of Miami.
For a second there, we just moved on past you. We were like, Alex must be done.
They were like, well, cat's out of the bag.
We're over it.
Yeah.
It's boring.
The horses left the barn.
So
guess what? It's
going to
rain
Florida.
In Florida. All right, good.
Yeah.
All right, well, here, just.
It's true. So sad.
Bye.
We still see you.
All right, now we're actually going to move on.
I'll be back.
We're heading to another active weather area because Alex is going to come back later and talk more about what's to come across the country. You're still on. Now you're making up for lost time.
I feel bad. They're giving you more time.
We're moving out west. Take a look at what the winds did in Reno, Nevada today. A semi-truck on its side. You got those winds blowing the trees around. Winds in excess of 50 miles per hour yesterday. And that was all out ahead of some of the precipitation, some snow moving into the area today. And here to talk about the very active west is our storm specialist, Sarah Dillingham. Sarah, man, it's like 4 storms in a row potentially coming towards the Pacific Northwest.
Yeah, now this is their more busy time of year. This is kind of their wet season. They're used to seeing these kinds of strong, windy storms that come through around October, November.
Yeah.
So it's not, you know, something that they're not used to. However, just a couple weeks ago, we remember the very intense winds that they had like in Spokane, Washington, and caused a lot of damage. Now, the good news is there's not like crazy precipitation right now, but Mark, it's out on the horizon. We'll take a little bit of a closer look. Seattle, you're still dry. Portland out there as well, just a few sprinkles. But the wind is still there, and we saw some of that damage from those overturned tractor trailers. We could continue to see that over the next couple of days. Now, Tom Nissel has been talking about this as well, this intense jet stream, and we've had this as high as 224 miles per hour here in this area. In
and
the North Pacific.
Potentially strengthening as we head through the weekend. So that wind energy not calming down as it moves the storms towards the Pacific Northwest.
Exactly right. And what does that do? It's basically going to have a couple of storm systems come through here through the Northwest. And we're going to kind of draw these in here. There's 1, 2, maybe 3 back here. So we've got like 1, 2, 3 storms in the hopper. It's just a storm train basically headed towards the Pacific Northwest.
And that means some real impacts, right? I mean, we're going to be seeing certainly some precipitation, but that wind energy, man, we know they're vulnerable after the last event just came through.
Very much so. And again, with any moist soils that they have, if they've had a lot of rain recently, which the reservoirs in Western Washington are doing quite well now after the recent rains that they've had. So that's going to help loosen the soils a little bit. So when we get these stronger wind events, it could potentially potentially lead to some downed trees and power lines as well. However, most of the strongest winds could stay just along the coast there and then the headlands there. So that is some good news, but some of those stronger winds could work their way inland, maybe 30 to 40 miles per hour. But by tomorrow morning, look at the big stream of moisture that comes in from Portland and Seattle. And you just really kind of see it heading to the coastline there as we go through the next 24 to 48 hours there. Interstate 90 getting a lot, maybe some rain and showers for Spokane. But Mark, these snow levels actually are not going to be that low, at least as we've gone into the overnight hours into today. They had the snow levels get down to about 3,500 feet in western Oregon, but for the duration of these events, we could see them around 5,000 to 7,000 feet in the Pacific Northwest. So not a lot of snow for those lower elevations.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, you just mentioned Seattle in a break. How about this view? You can see off in the distance the clouds of the next approaching system. So enjoy the break while you've got it, Seattle. A gorgeous sunset on the way because you can see that sun bouncing off the clouds.
What if you could
but
see Rainier
those clouds
today?
Are going to get much closer
bet.
In.
I bet you could see Rainier if you turn the other way.
It's a little probably. Almost a convective cloud top there.
Yeah,
the
yeah
sun
that's right.
Off of that.
Yeah,
that's
you're right.
That's interesting. Yeah. Yeah.
That's good stuff.
So it's a beautiful shot, but it's about to change. Want to bring in storm specialist Carl Parker as well as Tom Nizzle. And guys, we've got a lot to talk about here with regards to that snowy pattern and really the El Nino leading into this snowy pattern.
Right. Yeah, it's been a very interesting pattern. I think we've seen a fair amount of snow in the west. We've had a couple of events out into the plains. But you go east of the Mississippi, and other than northern Maine, there's been very little snow at all.
Yeah, and our storm tracks have been largely north, you know, as we've looked over the last couple of weeks. So, I mean, it's like that snow's not getting anywhere in the south. And even the Midwest and Northeast, they're running, you know, kind of behind in their snowfall that we've
seen. Yeah, you think about the difference between what's happening right now and what happened last year. We had this tremendous trough in the Northeast. Already by November, that had set up. It was incredibly cold across a lot of the east and the southeast.
That's, right.
That's the first thing, obviously, that you need for winter storms. But then on top of that, you've got a lot of warmth in the ocean and especially in the Gulf Stream. So you've got this zone that sets up, this baroclinic zone that we talk about. Mm-hmm. And along with that, you get explosive development of storms, a very strong jet stream. And so when you get these massive cold outbreaks in the east, it also often comes with major east coast storms. And without that, you don't get it as readily. We're going to see a pretty good low firing up along the coast there, but it's not going to have the cold air. It's not going to do much.
It's not there.
So, I mean, this year's storms, and really most of last year's storms, had a fairly similar start, a little origin coming in off to the Pacific Northwest, and then through the country, are these wasted winter storms? Is this just a waste of a good low?
Well, certainly this nor'easter to me is. It's a waste of a good winter storm because there's no cold air there.
Yeah, you're missing a key ingredient.
I'm sure hardy New Englanders are saying, hey, bring it on. If we're going to do it, we're going to get wind, we're going to get rain, you might as well give us the snow. Mm-hmm. But these were the tracks for our first four storms of this season. A lot of them starting out in the Pacific Northwest, coming down into the Four Corners region. So the snow cover out in the west is well above normal, but you can see other than one big event for Chicago, out to the east of us, it's all been well below normal.
Yeah, and you know, one of those storms, it was a decent ice-producing storm, and we had a decent snow-producing storm for Chicago, so when you get the ingredients there, we're ready. It's just hard to get all of them in place so far.
Yeah, it's been very difficult. And this is one of our storms that produced the snow across the Central Plains. That's beginning to melt away now, but it's due to the storm tracks that we saw. Take a look at the current snow cover. It's all in the west, a little bit in the upper Midwest from a couple of the storm tracks, but out to the east, there's been no cold air, no snow.
And talking about Karin and El Nino year, you tend to have a very active subtropical jet stream, and so this might be the year when we get more ice storms and maybe one for the southeast. It's been a long time since we've had one in Atlanta that really matter. That was a really big one.
Don't go there. We all know.
We don't want
that
again.
We all know how the Southeast cannot. We can't handle snow. We can't handle anything.
We'll wind up living in the cave for a few days. Still to come, you've heard of Dancing with the Devil, but what about Dancing with the Dust Devil? It's part of our Best of the Week video six pack. And see who made the cut and how you can vote for number one. And closer to compromise? We get a report from Paris to see if countries are in any closer now to an agreement about carbon emissions. Plus, we want to talk to you. We're going on Periscope now.
This is Pete. Pete is helping his aunt move, so he's not thinking about tires right now. But if he were, all he'd need to know is TireRack.com. He could view the complete selection of Continental tires at TireRack.com. Then he'd have the confidence to drive safely in any weather. But Pete's not thinking about tires. Pete's thinking it would have been nice if his aunt had mentioned the Minor Bird. TireRack.com. Find, deliver, install.
head around the corner to Walgreens when you're searching for that perfect little something. Walgreens has great gifts like toys, beauty gift sets, and photo gifts. And it's all just a hop, skip, and a bark away. Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy. This week, save 30% on photo gifts.
Hey, I'm here on the red carpet where our next arrival is. Whoa! Toenail fungus!
Fight it with Jublia. Jublia is a prescription medicine used to treat toenail fungus. Use Jublia as instructed by your doctor.
Are you getting this?
Most common side effects include ingrown toenail, application site redness, itching, swelling, burning or stinging, blisters, and pain.
Oh, epic moves, Big J!
Fight it!
Getting ready for your close-up? Ask your doctor if Jublia is right for you.
Visit our website for savings on larger size.
I love you.
Let me too.
Oh, I'm in it. Hi.
Dad.
We need to do this.
Letting go. It's a little easier when you've saved for college with State Farm.
Want to be the house that all the neighbors stop by to admire? Then stop by Ace. We'll help you find the right lights, cords, and decorations to make your house shine. Come in now and choose from a variety of long-lasting, energy-saving LED lights for just $15.99 each.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
When you've got a house full of guests on the way and a cold with sinus pressure, you need fast relief. Alka-Seltzer Plus Severe Sinus Congestion and Cough Liquid Gels rush relief to your tough symptoms to put you back in control.
Coming!
Alka-Seltzer Plus Sinus.
With Crizal No Glare lenses, neither scratch, nor smudge, nor glare of night can keep you from the clearest vision possible. Plus, Crizal gives you the most comprehensive UV protection. Crizal No Glare lenses. Live life in the clear.
Intel's best processor is here, and it helps PCs wake up instantly, just like you did.
That's great, but do you mind?
No, I don't mind.
Introducing Intel's new 6th generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
The way I see it, you have two choices. The easy way or the hard way. You could choose a card that limits where you earn bonus cash back, or you could make things easier on yourself. That's right, the Quicksilver card from Capital One. With Quicksilver, you earn unlimited 1.5% cash back on every purchase everywhere. So let's try this again. What's in your wallet?
WeatherTech is the ultimate way to protect your vehicle this holiday season with laser-measured floor liners for a perfect fit. Order the perfect holiday gift today at WeatherTech.com. The ultimate protection for your vehicle. Happy holidays from WeatherTech.
We experienced our first Northeast winter.
We were freezing.
So we went to Burlington. There's so many brands to choose from.
That looks good on you.
We found something for everybody.
And the prices are great. This year, we're prepared.
Yes!
Stanley Steamer is the first carpet cleaning service certified asthma and allergy friendly. It's our new standard of clean. Call about our $99 carpet cleaning special.
Call 1-800-STEAMER. Stanley Steamer, your certified.
It is time now for the video six pack. Keith Carson standing by. We've got several videos that were in the running this week.
Yeah, so we're gonna recap your best ones for you and make your vote on the number one.
Yeah.
All right, let's start in Russia, where they had quite a bit of heavy snow and deadly cold snap there. You know, you think about talking about how the East is so warm. Well, this reaction's throughout the atmosphere, and that is not the case here in Russia, the Ukraine. Heavy snow stranded some drivers, and unfortunately, 37 people killed in this bitter cold snap. So much different picture there than we're seeing in the East. Number five, Miami Beach. Speedos and thongs, not the only thing putting on shows in Miami Beach this weekend. Check this out. Lightning strike right on cue there. This is one of the high rises along the beach line. By the way, a lot of rain in Miami, setting a record today. And number four, let's keep with the lightning theme. Check out this bolt captured by a driver in Queensland, Australia. Well, they were driving, and I'm trying to figure out, guys, are they driving or, because what side is their steering wheel in Australia? Does anyone know off the top of their head?
I think it's the other side.
Other side. So, okay, so they're cool. So they're good. So they're not driving. Pretty cool lightning strike there, though. All right, let's go to Australia again. Last night's winner,
Dirty Dancing, not just for Patrick Swayze and Jennifer Grey. Many concert goers here dancing with this dust devil. We talked about in the break on Periscope whether or not you should do this. The answer in the room was yes. The real life answer is not so much, but generally not too damaging. Usually just spinning around some debris there. People were into it. All right. By the way, that spun in the opposite direction you'd expect. Let's have you choose which ones should win tonight. On the left, a puppy, husky puppy, encountered its first ice this weekend. We're going to make this close, though, because on the right, we've got a flyby, an aborted landing here in Manchester because of very strong winds. So we will make you choose hashtag WooTV and then hashtag husky or hashtag flyby. Mark, this is one of the closer votes we're going to have in a while. All week, they've been really easy decisions.
You know, you'd think that the husky would automatically win because puppies. Cute animals, puppies, yep. And weather seem to be guarantees, but that plane video is pretty cool, too.
The flyby is cool.
Yeah. All right. Thanks so much, Keith. We'll go back to you for what they decided on out there in the world. All right, the Paris climate talks, though, are wrapping up their first week with an important deadline just hours away. So we sent a University of Michigan student majoring in climate science to the conference, and here's our final report from Matt Irish.
Good evening, everybody. It's Matt Irish here again, and we are on the fifth day of negotiations. And I'm talking to you outside because it's our first sunny day that we've gotten all week here in Paris, but also because we're right here at about the intersection between two different opposing moods that I've noticed emerging over the last 2 days. So over here on our right, we have the buildings where the negotiations themselves have been going on. Things have been getting a little bit tense often and somewhat slowed down in the last 2 days. While parties try to work out some of their differences. They have the deadline of tomorrow to actually finish the text and send it onward to the ministers who will be arriving next week. The United Nations process works solely off of consensus. There's no voting or anything like that. So 196 countries have to all agree on every single word of every single line of text in this agreement. So it's somewhat understandable things have been going slow. But they have a deadline by tomorrow, at which time they have to finalize this thing and move it on to the ministers that will be arriving next week, who will then work on it, make higher level compromises and decisions that maybe these parties can't make now. And by next Friday, the agreement is supposed to be adopted.
All right, thanks so much, Matt. Meanwhile, a global 2 degrees Celsius temperature increase could decide our future. The meetings in Paris on climate change are trying to prevent that. And some organizations say we're already halfway there. So we want to bring in our own Weather Underground meteorologist, Bob Henson, joining us to put those numbers in perspective. Bob, what does that mean? Halfway to the 2C change, what does it mean in impacts for the world?
Well, it's pretty significant that we're already halfway, you know, and El Nino has certainly helped push us there this year. You know, to some extent, these effects are linear. So if you warm up twice as much, 2 degrees Celsius, you're going to get twice the impact in some ways. Sea level rise is a good example of that. Other effects are a little more nonlinear, meaning that they could depend on things that are a little more difficult to predict and things that don't operate quite so straightforwardly. So we'll have to see how those unfold. I mean, sea ice melt in the Arctic is a good example of that.
All right, Bob, and we have another question for you that we want you to think about for a bit, right? Some reports say that we're halfway. We want to know what people can do right now at home to help. If they're hearing about what's happening in Paris and they want to do real actions themselves that can contribute to helping, and we don't want your answer yet, we're going to come back to you right after the break so that you have a chance to, you know, give us your best guesses. So we'll be back to you in just a second. But here's the thing. We've got so much more to talk about here, including all of this. We're going to test your knowledge with a little Woo IQ. And here's the question. What is the most snow ever recorded in a 24-hour period? Is it 78, 91, or 112 inches? Think about that, and you'll get the answer right after the break as well.
Being a gamer can be a profession.
Phil!
Oh.
Hey, man.
Hey, Peter.
Oh. Joanne, is that you?
It's me.
You don't look a day over 70, am I right?
If you're Peter Pan, you stay young forever. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. So it's what you do.
You make me feel so spring has sprung.
I'm ready. Intel's best processor is here. So you can take this very real, very terrifying memory and edit it, share it, play it back.
Introducing Intel's new sixth generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
Where's the rain that's happening right now as you walk out the door?
A lot of people traveling, but we'll keep an eye on it for you.
Because the weather impacts your day in 100 ways you see and 1,000 ways you don't.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
So include us in your routine.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees with showers. Tonight, cloudy with periods of rain, low 70. Rainfall around a half an inch. Saturday, cloudy with occasional rain showers, high 79, chance of rain 80%. Saturday night, variable clouds with showers and scattered thunderstorms, low 74. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome to Gift Headquarters. I got two of their favorite toys for under $20.
Great price.
Thank you, Burlington.
I love Rudy's smile, so I give him these Milk-Bone brushing chews. It's a treat that's proven to clean as well as a toothbrush to help keep his teeth and gums clean and healthy.
This is my favorite.
Say it with Milk-Bone.
Lowe's presents How to Make a Snowman While Eating a Turkey Leg.
Now get up to 30% off select Christmas decorations at Lowe's.
Feeling cold? Try Hot Hands. Simply open the package and they heat up quickly. Quick, long-lasting warm. Go get your own.
The more confident you are starting a meeting, the more confident you'll be in it. Let's put it to the test. Connect with your team in 10 seconds or your chute will deploy. Ready, set, go. Not go to meeting. Feeling confident?
Yep, just a second.
Go to meeting. How about you?
Abby, see the chart on slide 5. Great, let's start there.
Not go to meeting. You connected?
How do I look?
Good job, go to meeting. GoToMeeting, the most trusted web conferencing tool, hosting over 50 million meetings a year.
Mondays on the Weather Channel. When nature is this dangerous, only one question matters.
Oh my God!
So you think you'd survive? All new Mondays at 10, only on the Weather Channel.
Before the break, we asked Weather Underground, we asked this question. What is the most snow ever recorded in a 24-hour period? Was it 78, 91, or 112 inches? And we got the answer for you as well. It is 78, believe it or not. This was recorded in Alaska at one of the camp mile markers along the way. Unbelievable amounts of snowfall in just 24 hours. I would like to see that one, but also have a way out of town. Also before the break, we asked Weather Underground meteorologist Bob Henson about how you can help in combating climate change. Everyone talking about Paris and talking about this big meeting and the 2C. You know, it sounds like such a small number, but there's real impacts. And if you want to help, how can you do it?
There are ways you could do it. And I should say that being an informed citizen is really important. So, you know, letting your congresspeople know what it is you want, working with nonprofits and so forth. But as an individual, there are things you can do too. And some of them are not the obvious ones. First off, make sure your house is efficient, you know, heating and cooling. You know, insulating your house, it's not very sexy, but it can make a big difference and save you money as well. Number two area that we may not think of is what we eat. Believe it or not, just shifting a little more toward a plant-centered diet can make a big difference in greenhouse emissions. And a third area that is one we think about maybe a little more is how we get around. And certainly more fuel-efficient vehicles, combining trips, walking and biking when you can, and even just flying. If you have to fly, a nonstop flight is usually more efficient than, say, a two- or three-stop flight because the plane doesn't have to go up and down and then back up again.
Yeah, those takeoffs use a lot of the fuel just to get up to speed. Bob, we did hear that the UN Climate Change Agency is reporting maybe some progress here, that they're saying things look optimistic at the moment?
I think there is going to be an agreement. Some of the big questions are how flexible will the agreement be? Because whatever agreement there is, it's going to be a little bit short of the goal of where we need to be. So one big sticking point or point of discussion is how often will these goals be addressed? And I believe the U.S. and some other countries are pushing for every 5 years. Other countries are nervous and saying, well, maybe every 10 years. And I think it is crucial to review those often because, you know, there are surprises along the way. And it's going to be hard to get everybody on the same page at all for an agreement. But I am optimistic that'll happen this time around.
Especially when it comes to the developing versus the developed nations, and everybody has to come to one answer. Bob Henson, Weather Underground meteorologist, thanks so much for your time tonight.
Sure, thank you.
A lot to follow from Paris, that's for sure. We also have this for you. Picture this, right? We've got a great shot of clouds coming through from Kerry Pool. This is Canandaigua in New York. And this is just an epic shot. There's a lot that you might pick out, but a lot that you might not see right away. For example, we've got the clear skies above, right? It looks like a fairly nice evening setting up with the clearing overhead, but that might not tell the whole story. Yes, it is sunset. You can see some of the beautiful colors illuminating on the clouds, and there are different clouds out there. You're starting to pick up on those as well. Like these, the stratocumulus clouds in the foreground here that may have contributed to some of this, right? We've got some wet pavement nearby. But the big question mark is, what is this off in the distance? Some people saying mountain range, but no, that is actually a lake effect snow band that rolled through the area, contributed to some of these wet roads, and really set the stage for a magnificent sunset. That one is just a great version of the picture this, and thank you so much, Carrie, for sending this one in. Not a bad way to pull over on your drive home and see a shot like that one.
Wow.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Free
commercial, too.
It's a great area, too. Canandaigua, New York, at the head of Canandaigua Lake in the Finger Lakes.
And figures that our Tom Nizzle would know all about that place, right? Time for you to sound off. Social meteorologist Ryan Davison has been hard at work behind the bar, combing through your questions. We got the whole gang here. Ryan, what's coming up with sounding off?
All right, we have time for one question.
Okay.
From Sal, probably good for Carl.
And Sal says, what has ever happened to acid rain since it's no longer mentioned? And does acid rain give rise to acid snow or acid ice?
Yeah, you know, it certainly does, and it's still a problem. It's more of a problem in the Northeast and Midwest than anywhere else in the country, and it's still there, and it's still affecting the forests, and it's affecting wildlife and the lakes and the rivers. I think it's faded a little bit from attention because of the climate change problem, which is enormous, but it's still a problem, no doubt about that.
That's a good point. I hadn't even thought about it until that question. People don't really talk about it.
You
anymore.
Really don't. Yeah.
There was a lot of work in the Clean Air Act, as well as taking some stuff out of fuels and our pesticides that help that problem a little bit, but it's still out there.
There's still coal-fired power plants.
Yes.
You got that in the Ohio Valley, Ohio region. The Northeast is still downwind, and they get the acid rain.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And we're going to get to more of your questions as the show goes on, so don't worry about that. But right now, we want to take a live look at Atlanta. The city will host one of the biggest football games of the year tomorrow, the SEC Championship game. Alabama and Florida, just a huge playoff implication in that one. But it's a dome. Doesn't mean that we can't get some impacts for those of you traveling to the game. Keith, there's a lot of weather involved across the college football landscape.
Yeah, you know, you're right. It's a dome in Georgia Dome. And really what we're talking about here for the most part is going to be tailgate weather, right? What's going on for Alabama versus the Gators here. And actually, it's going to be really nice in Atlanta. Temperatures in the 50s there and then into the 40s later on in the evening. So no problem there. Wouldn't have been anyways because of the dome. Let's talk about the Cougars versus the Owls. We'll go a little off there, 19 and 22. Again, nice and sunny. sunny. A big ridge of high pressure over the middle part of the country. Eastern two-thirds of the country quiet as well. Kind of continues into the NFL weekend, by the way. The only games that would have problems would be in Seattle, and they're not playing at home this week. And then we have Stanford versus USC. A lot of people feel like Stanford could potentially sneak in to the college football playoffs if they can win and get a couple of lucky breaks. Weather will not be a factor for them tomorrow at 4:45 Pacific time. Temperatures in the upper 50s. Some clouds. It is active weather-wise in California, but most of the weather will stay in Washington and Oregon.
Mark? Keith, thanks so much. Lots of weather involved for your college football games, at least the tailgaters. Alex, a lot to follow with what's happening right now and over the next 24 hours.
Yeah, what do you say we get a quick look before we start the new hour? We're going to take you up into parts of the Northeast where we've got some snow showers coming down into far northern reaches of New York and Vermont, up not too far from the Burlington area. Also notice through Maine, a few light snow showers, but the snow yesterday has really come to an end. Temperatures right now, not too chilly. Mid-40s for Boston, upper 40s, New York, Philly, D.C. We've got 39 in Boston, 37 in Binghamton. Tomorrow, sunshine down the I-95 corridor. Chicago's at 47, Indianapolis, 48. Louisville, 54 this time of year. Really not bad. And Sunday, yeah, toasty, Mark said. And you're right. Look at that, mid-50s from Boston to New York to D.C. New York, you are well above average into the end of next week. Weather underground rolls on right now.
And we thank all of you for staying with us. I am Mark Elliott. Mike Bettis is off today, but he'll be back on Monday, so never fear, your fearless leader will be back before too much longer. So here's what's on tap for what's still to come this hour. We've got a soaked South Florida, a very stormy Pacific Northwest, and our video six-pack, the best weather of the week. But we got to start off in Florida. Man, you have been getting hammered. Days straight of record rain, and it's still falling. We'll tell you how many more inches they could see before it's all over. We'll also go across the country, the stormy Pacific Northwest. It's a destructive storm that's bringing heavy rain, snow, and wind. Millions of people could once again lose power after last week's debacle. Will they get the lights back on before the next big storm comes charging through? Plus, it's our video six-pack, some awesome clips that we need you to help with choosing the best one. Will it be hashtag Husky or hashtag Flyby? You can see both the options on the screen, but there's a lot more to talk about with both those videos, so vote right now. That's what we need you to do. Meanwhile, it's shaping up to be another very soggy night in South Florida. We've been following this for you. Days of rain have dumped 3 months worth of rainfall, and some areas got as much as 3 inches per hour. Look at that. I mean, how could the streets and the drains compete with that at all? At 6 a.m. this morning, Miami had already set a daily rainfall record, and then the rain continued, and that flood threat stretches into tomorrow. So let's show you why we're seeing such a soggy setup. Cold front has come down through the southeast. Lots of dry air here, and you can see that leading edge of the dry air. There's a problem, though. It's not going to get all the way into the southeast, and the southeast corner of Florida, I should say. Instead, the southerly flow there is still dominating. So that's something that we're going to watch very carefully. Within this zone, we've got a lot of rain that's still nearby. Some of it is now off the coast. We're going to zoom in just a little bit further for you. How about this? Traveling down I-75 and doing the big turn across the state, north of Alligator Alley and the Everglades to head towards Fort Lauderdale and Miami, it is raining and raining hard along that whole route right now. In fact, within this zone, we've seen some pretty substantial accumulations. Let's just look at the past 3 hours. Over portions of that I-75 corridor, we have had some areas that have picked up several inches of rain already. An inch there, we've got an inch nearby just south of the highway. And with that, you know, that is just on top of what we've already seen today. So we'll go back to the radars now and show you where that rain is now and really where it's going from here. Because, hey, you've had some record rains across the zone today. So that's something that we're following. Your forecast here as we use our high resolution radar, we'll loop this for you. And man, it's showing the I-75 corridor as well as kind of the Keys in South Florida could see a secondary round of rain building in as we go through the rest of the day. which is just insult on top of injury, considering how much rain we've seen as of late. The past three-day total rainfall from Wednesday through today is now at 5.34 inches. That is getting very close to your typical entire year. The average winter rainfall, 5.9. Whew. This time of year, we're usually talking more about snow and epic snow records falling, but maybe not so much right now. Take a look at the map right now. It is really quiet considering that this is the first week of December. I mean, where's the snow? What happened here? We've got the rain in Florida. We've got the mess in the Pacific Northwest, maybe. And then there's nothing in between. So why are we seeing so little snow so far this season?
Well, it's
you
nothing,
might sneeze at it.
Nothing to sneeze at.
Winter
yeah.
weather expert Tom Nizzle is here as well. Is this an El Nino effect? Is this because of the big pattern that we're seeing taking hold?
Well, I certainly think that's driving it. In fact, you take a look at the jet stream here, and it really is working its way from west to east. It's more of what we refer to as a zonal pattern. And the
right.
jet stream separates two different air masses, right? Cold and warm. All that cold air locked up in northern Canada. And, you know, it's actually into parts of northern Canada. We're looking at some of the temperature departures across southern and central Canada, even well to the north of us, and it's going to be very mild. So there you have it right there. The mild temperatures across the region over the next several days.
I mean, portions of Canada that normally see low temperatures at 5 below are seeing low temperatures at 20.
Which 15 is to 20 degrees, which is crazy for them.
Still no. above freezing, below freezing, but still really far above average.
Yeah, and here in from the upper Midwest over through the Great Lakes, 10, 15, 20 degrees above normal for this time of the year, and I don't see that abating in a lot of those areas for a while.
It's hard to talk snow or even think of snow when Bismarck is going to be near 50 and International Falls are going to be near 50 degrees.
Yeah, those are crazy numbers. I haven't seen that since, well, it's been 3 years ago now where they had that kind of weather up there. But you take a look at the month of December overall, and the only place that's really below average is going to be across the south, and that's probably due to more stormy conditions just keeping the daytime highs down. But up north, it's going to remain very warm. Now, if we take a look at a week-by-week basis, next week, it is ridiculously warm across the northern U.S. and the eastern U.S., about the only place, the southwest, where the mountains could see snow. We do begin to see a change here in the 14th through 21st, because look at the cold air building into the west. That comes out of the Gulf of Alaska. So the west is going to turn on to snow. But
and then this week is Christmas week, so people are hoping for some cold.
Yeah, but take a look at the east again. Everything certainly east of the Mississippi Valley and much of the upper Midwest right now is going to stay warm. If you want to go skiing, you want to do any outdoor winter recreation, you got to head to the western mountains.
And is that kind of that pattern of storms coming into the west that will contribute to that below average temperature regime?
Not only
out there?
The below average temps, but a lot of snow at higher elevations as well.
Now, speaking of snow, that we have on the ground may be disappearing as well.
Yeah.
You know, and not in the way that you might expect it. So coming up next, maybe you've noticed this. Some snow disappearing even on days that stay well below freezing. Well, coming up next, Tom and I are going to head up to the lab. We're going to teach you the science of sublimation as well as answer some of your questions. Man, look what happened to that block in the past hour. That's impressive on its own. Also, the Pacific Northwest is getting slammed by storm after storm. Millions of people could start their weekend without any power. We're going to show you where the worst damage could be. And there's still time to vote. Your two videos are on the screen, right? You can use hashtag Husky or hashtag Flyby. Man, great videos there. But before we go to break, we want to check in with Alex Wilson. Alex, bring us the weather conditions right now. What are you watching across the country?
Well, I'm watching that plane, and I was telling everybody at home, too, that makes me sweat looking at that. Like, when I'm on a plane and it's taking off, my feet sweat. I didn't even know your feet can sweat.
I get a little bit nervous when it starts getting too bumpy.
Tom Nizzle's very puzzled about the foot sweat thing. I didn't think it could happen physiologically. No.
And especially not in those shoes.
No. I mean, I'll slip out of everything. All right, now to the weather I'm watching, because I got to get that plane off my mind. 67 in Los Angeles, pretty quiet across the southwest. We got 71 in Phoenix, 43 for Flagstaff. San Francisco, where they'd love to see some rain, but only going to get up to an inch. Temps in the upper 50s. That parade of storms impacting the west. You heard Mark mention that we could be seeing wind damage issues. We're going to see a lot of rain into coastal parts of Washington and Oregon, even far northwest California. This just stream, this feed of moisture working into the northwest. More rain, more wind coming this weekend and then the same again early next week. So really a consistent pattern for the next week or so. Sunday across the Southwest, though, look, we're dry. San Francisco is about as far south as those showers look to go. By Monday, back up into parts of the Northwest, so even San Francisco will be drying out. Los Angeles, though, you've got mostly sunny to partly cloudy skies through the weekend and into early next week, with temps in the upper 70s Monday and Tuesday. We're back after your local news.
Intel's best processor is here, which gives new PCs three times the battery life, so you never have to stop watching.
Thanks.
Introducing Intel's new 6th generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
When it's your job to protect the world's greatest nation, it's your responsibility to solve the world's greatest challenges. This is why we search for the best and brightest, why we train for every eventuality, on land and water, in the air, space, and even cyberspace. We operate in a complex world with one simple mission: win.
Oh man, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Harry.
You gotta do it like this. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, George.
Hey, Jim.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
When your cold makes you wish you could stay in bed all day, you need the power of new Theraflu Express Max. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
What's this?
A box. It takes worn out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
It's easy to love your laxative when that lax loves your body back. Only Miralax hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative, Miralax.
If you take multiple medications, a dry mouth can be a common side effect. That's why there's Biotene. It comes in oral rinse, spray, or gel, so there's moisturizing relief for everyone. Biotene, for people who suffer from a dry mouth.
The wonder of a credit card may help you out right now. Your family wants a nice Christmas, but you are no cash cow. Spend that amount and find yourself with a little credit burst. $35 in credit reimbursed. Just open one first for a credit card right in your little purse.
No, this is a satchel. It's like fashion forward type thing.
It's a purse.
Open a Walmart credit card account today and save $35 when you spend $75. Our best offer ever. Walmart.
I would ask you to look at the good. There is no war, no disease.
You deserve to know the truth about what they are.
Childhood's End starts December 14th on Sci-Fi.
Monday on AMHQ, will Florida's weekend storms continue into your work week? Plus, will the warmer than average temperatures wreck your chance for a white Christmas? That's Monday at 5 a.m. on AMHQ.
Welcome back, everybody. How about this? We've been following Sioux City, Iowa, with the snow that fell this week. Nearly 10 inches fell throughout the city, and all that snow hasn't melted away, right? Temperatures are still below freezing, and they have been for most of the week. But still, that snow depth has been slowly eroding and going away. But it's due to something else, and we're going to show you how that snow has been disappearing. Basically right now, don't go anywhere, right? We're in the lab here. Our winter weather expert, Tom Nizzle, is joining me. And Tom, we've been talking about this snow and talking about the snow that's been slowly disappearing and how that might happen.
Yeah, and there's a number of ways it can disappear. Yeah. You know, the first way is the temperature gets above freezing.
That's the easy way.
The snow melts, yeah. Right? You see little puddles of water all over the place. But there's another way that snow can melt. When the temperature is below freezing, the sun is out, a nice sunny day hitting that snowpack, we still lose snowfall, don't we? And it goes through a process of what we refer to as sublimation. So here's the snowpack across the plains from the other day, and this is a visible loop here throughout the day, and it actually, you can see the snowpack here. We'll zoom in on that, and you can see throughout the day it kind of begins to erode from the edges here, and we've been losing that snowpack over the last 3 or 4 days.
Now, some of these areas, right on the fringes especially, where the sun was able to hit some bare ground and warm up the air, got above freezing, but there's areas like Sioux City where it didn't get above freezing.
Sioux City in particular only gets to 28 degrees. How is the snow going to melt? Well, it doesn't melt. It sublimates, and it's a very interesting process.
Yeah, so. Different process, but a similar result as the melting.
That's correct. So let's take a look at snow that melts. So the air temperature gets well above the freezing mark. The sun is beating down on it during the daytime, and the snow melts away here.
This is Frosty turning into the puddle, what you would expect to see. But there are days where it stays below freezing, yet you've watched that snow pile disappear.
And very often during the midwinter, when you get to northern latitudes or down into Antarctica as an example, where that temperature stays well below the freezing mark, there's enough sun that is hitting that snowpack, and that energizes the molecules right at the surface, is down at a molecular level. Some of them begin to release into the air, but they release in the form of the gaseous form of ice and then water, which is water vapor.
So basically, in this case, what we're saying is the sun is giving enough energy to the snow to move those molecules around and turn it into a liquid. And it would happen here, too, but it can't turn into a liquid because it's still below the freezing line.
That's correct. And so we end up sublimating or going right to the gaseous state.
That sun continues to kind of bubble in, give more and more energy, and eventually, pop, you can get some of those molecules to leave in the gaseous form. And we can actually show this in a slightly different way.
Yeah, so we'll bring our board over with us. And this is a great example here. Carl Parker brought this to our attention here. And it really is... this is the best example of sublimation. So what we have here is carbon dioxide in its solid state, which we refer to as dry ice.
Okay. And so tell us a little bit about what's happening here.
Well, carbon dioxide is a very, very interesting molecule here because what happens with this is it actually goes into its gaseous state even at exceptionally cold temperatures, down around 60, 70 below zero. So it, here in this pressure, in this situation, it's not going to go to a melting state, but immediately goes to the gaseous state. And you can see that with all of the mist that is coming off of these blocks of ice.
And so that is the solid going directly into a gas.
Correct. And this is what happens in that snowpack when our temperatures are below 32 degrees, and it actually gets exacerbated or increased when you get some wind that blows across it. I'll do it in this fashion. And that just increases the rate of cooling as molecules move away from this and in drier air as well.
So if you have a cold, dry, windy day, you'll see your snowpack disappearing.
Absolutely.
That's awesome. And if you have questions about sublimation, we want to hear from you. I'm all choked up about it, breathing in the CO2.
Correct.
Use the hashtag WUTV, and our team of experts will answer them live on the show. And still to come this hour, we've told you that snow could be hard to come by for much of the country due to El Nino, but we'll show you why that same El Nino could mean more dangerous ice storms.
Bountiful, healthy weight is so good, and low calorie. Keeps me looking good. Hey, I get some looks. I hear the whistles.
Beneful Healthy Weight, a delicious low-calorie meal your dog will love with wholesome rice, real chicken, and accents of vegetables and apples.
The cold truth is, if a cold keeps you up at night, you can't just catch up on sleep the next day. New Alka-Seltzer Plus Night Cold and Cough Liquid relieves tough cold symptoms and quiets coughs for up to 8 hours to help you sleep at night. New Alka-Seltzer Plus Night Liquid.
I found a better deal on prescriptions.
We found lower copays.
And a free wellness visit. New plan, same doctor. I'm happy.
It's Medicare open enrollment. Have you compared plans yet?
It's easy at Medicare.gov.
Or you can call 1-800-MEDICARE.
Medicare open enrollment. You'll never know unless you go.
I did it. You can too.
I'm Mike Bettis. That's Sarah.
Hi.
Welcome to the set of a brand new show, Weather Underground. There'll be experts, bloggers, the smartest weather minds in the business on every screen you have 24 hours a day. Geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6.
Experience all the fun of a two-night Bahamas Paradise cruise for the amazing low price of just $109. For $109, you'll enjoy a two-night Bahamas cruise that includes five-course dining, spectacular live shows, luxurious spa, lots of fun on the ship, and more fun in the Bahamas. If you're looking for a longer vacation, add a two- or four-night Bahamas stay to your cruise at the beautiful all-inclusive Grand Lucayan Resort. Enjoy spa spectacular white sand beaches, family fun, fine dining, golf, and so much more. A two-night Bahamas cruise for just $109 with an option to add a Bahamas resort stay is an amazing deal and the best value anywhere. This $109 price won't last. So call 800-814-7100. That's 800-814-7100. 800-814-7100.
Getting you ready for the winter and holiday gifts with the season in mind.
It all starts at 5 a.m. on AMHQ Weekend and Weekend Recharge.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8s brought to you by the 306 horsepower Lexus GS. Experience it, and there is no going back.
Conquer the weather. Don't let it conquer you. With the capability and adaptability of Lexus all-weather drive, this is the pursuit of perfection.
You know the love you feel for Olive Garden's fresh baked breadsticks? Well, multiply that by a million. New breadstick sandwiches, part of Olive Garden's lunch duo, starting at $6.99.
Santa has a magic snow globe for every family. And this year, look at what he put in our driveway.
The Lexus December to Remember sales event is here. Lease the 2016 ES350 for $349 a month for 36 months. And we'll make your first month's payment. See your Lexus dealer.
Currently in our area, 72 degrees with light rain. Tonight, rain, low 71. Winds northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Rainfall around a half an inch. Saturday, cloudy with occasional rain showers. High 79. Chance of rain, 80%. Saturday night, variable clouds with showers and scattered thunderstorms. Low 74. Chance of rain, 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
You know, we say it's amazing out there, but you guys help to prove it. Awesome weather photos that you guys send in each and every day. I want to show you this sunset over Black Lake in Winter Garden, Florida. I mean, just look at the sky. It is on fire here. They say that clouds are really what help to make a sunset, a magnificent and stunning sunset. And you can see why here. Not only do you have the sun kind of reflecting and bouncing off the clouds with those extra colors, but here you get the added bonus of the water underneath. So that's an added layer of reflection of those amazing sunset colors. I don't know if it gets any better than this, to tell you the truth. With the dock there, it's framed beautifully. This person knew what they were doing when taking photos. It is just a magnificent example of why we say it's amazing out there. And I would just want to take a seat at the end of that dock underneath the gazebo and just watch the sun go down each and every day. That is a stunning view. Meanwhile, you in your hometown might have a stunning view for us. You can send in your pictures or become a personal weather station owner and potentially talk to us here. Jerry Callahan joins us from Zion, Illinois. That's about an hour north of Chicago. Hey, you got some snow recently, right? How much did you record at the home device?
We got lots of snow on November 20th. Wet, heavy snow that was at least 4 inches. I forget exactly the amount, but it had the trees bent over and everything.
Tell us a little bit about what you saw at your personal weather station. Did anything surprise you either during that snowstorm or really with the warm up that's happened since?
Well, all of the snow is gone, so that's kind of surprising. We've had some warm weather come through. It hit 50 today, and there is absolutely no snow left on the ground whatsoever. But what surprised me about that snowstorm was how wet it was. I mean, it was so heavy, trees were breaking. There was It was just nasty. Trying to move it was terrible.
And quickly, in your years of being a personal weather station owner, have you really seen a lot of 50-degree temperatures this time of year?
It's rather unusual, but it's not that totally uncommon for early December. Later in December, if it's this temperature, we've got some strange weather.
Yeah, absolutely. Hey, thanks so much for joining us and for being a personal weather station user. Enjoyed talking with you.
My pleasure.
And, you know, you guys have been sounding off as well. Our social meteorologist, Ryan Davidson, has been hard at work behind the bar, combing through your comments and your questions. So let's get right on into some of these questions for the sounding off. Ryan, what have you been following?
Everybody's been talking about their snow and El Niño's effects, and they want to know more about sublimation.
So we've got a lot to go through.
We do.
So let's get right on into it. Here's the first one. Does that dry ice demo also apply to evaporative cooling and snowflakes as they fall and overcome the dry air? Tom?
Yeah, I mean, the snowflakes, when they fall through the atmosphere, can go through all of that. They can melt and then evaporate, so liquid state and then to the gaseous state. But falling through dry air that is below 32 degrees, that process is actually sublimating. So snowflakes can go through all of that.
Kind of the virga of snowflakes, right? You have them falling into the, but it's still dry and cold, and so they have to go back into the water vapor state.
And that process releases it into that state.
All right. Yep. Great answer there. And of course, we've got more. We've got more questions coming on in. How about this one from Bosco Weather says, question, what do you think about the coastal storm for the East Coast on Tuesday? Is it possible? Will it be a nor'easter? How have the models been trending?
Okay, I don't know that I would even call it a nor'easter at this point. More an Atlantic gale, a storm that is further off the coast. The GFS, our American model, is still showing a wound-up tight system that would produce a lot of wind around the coast. The latest European model run continues to weaken the center of that low, so it's looking less and less likely, and certainly at this point, absolutely no chance for snow.
It's too warm for snow, but the Mariners still got to watch that one. Any boaters, any shipping lanes, that will be a real impact storm.
Very important.
All right. We want to hear from you. You've heard from us, but it's your turn, right? We want to know which video is the number one video. Is it the pup on ice or is it the plane caught in the crosswinds? You voted one of these as the best video of the week. Learn which one slided or glided right on in to the top spot. Either way, you might be losing your footing just a little bit. Stick around. Weather Underground comes right back.
When I lay in my Tempur-Pedic contour, the next thing I know, it's morning.
With Tempur-Flex, you've got the spring and bounce of a traditional mattress. Then it also adjusts to my body.
My cloud feels like somebody's hugging you. How can a bed do that?
There's a Tempur-Pedic for everyone.
Minions!
Minions with three all-new mini-movies. Get an exclusive lunch bag when you buy the Blu-ray. Only at Best Buy this Tuesday.
Every insurance policy has a number, but not every insurance company understands the life behind it. For those who've served and the families who've supported them, we offer our best service in return. USAA, we know what it means to serve. Get an insurance quote and see why 92% of our members plan to stay for life.
I love Rudy's smile, so I give him these Milk-Bone brushing chews. It's a treat that's proven to clean as well as a toothbrush to help keep his teeth and gums clean and healthy.
This is my favorite.
Say it with Milk-Bone.
You owned your car for 4 years. You named it Brad. You loved Brad, and then you totaled him. You two had been through everything together. Two boyfriends, three jobs. You're like, nothing can replace Brad. Then Liberty Mutual calls, and you break into your happy dance.
If you sign up for Better Car Replacement, we'll pay for a car that's a model year newer with 15,000 fewer miles than your old one. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Want to be the house that all the neighbors stop by to admire? Then stop by Ace. We'll help you find the right lights, cords, and decorations to make your house shine. Come in now and choose from a variety of long-lasting, energy-saving LED lights for just $15.99 each.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Here's something new. Now you can get the Weather Channel forecast on the new L.L. Bean app. Just tap, shop, and discover. The new app from L.L. Bean, featuring forecasts from the Weather Channel. Download today.
It's
shake.
Lose weight fast with Slim Fast Advanced Shakes. Replace a meal with one of four delicious new flavors, like creamy chocolate, with 20 grams of protein, 1 gram of sugar, and 100% daily fiber. Slim Fast Advanced Shakes. It's your thing.
I asked my dentist if an electric toothbrush was going to clean better than a manual. He said, sure, but don't get just anyone. Get one inspired by dentists with a round brush head.
Go pro with Oral-B. Oral-B's rounded brush head cups your teeth to break up plaque and rotates to sweep it away. And Oral-B delivers a clinically proven superior clean versus Sonicare Diamond Clean.
My mouth feels super clean.
Oral-B. Know you're getting a superior clean.
I'm never going back to a manual brush.
Feeling cold? Try Hot Hands. Simply open the package and they heat up quickly. Quick, long-lasting warmth. Go get your own. Hot Hands. Bring the heat.
This holiday season, no matter where you travel, the best way to watch Minions is to own it on Blu-ray.
There's something different about Kevin.
Hello.
Get a Blu-ray, DVD, and digital version.
Kingdom!
Minions with three all-new mini-movies. Own it on Blu-ray this Tuesday.
Closed captioning brought to you by Maglite Flashlights.
Today we're getting record snowfall.
Radars indicate there's been flooding throughout the area.
We're getting hail the size of golf balls.
Maglite. Turn your light on, America.
Yay! All right, it's time for a new segment we're calling Rapid Fire, a recap of the biggest weather stories of the day. So 30 seconds on the clock. I'm going in. We're talking about the Soaker of South Florida, record-breaking rains for Miami, and it has been raining, right? And nothing changing. In fact, as we go through the next 24 hours, additional rain is in our forecast, several inches of rain at that. In fact, right around Miami to Fort Lauderdale, we'll get a little bit closer in. You might see your hometown. How about this? Anywhere from 2 to 3, if not 3 to 5 additional inches of rain. Let's bring in storm specialist Sarah Dillingham. She's got to look at the wet and windy weather in the Northwest. Okay. 30 seconds.
All right, Mark, I'm going to steal the controls from you. All right, so we've already seen a couple systems come through the Northwest. And look, we've got 1, 2, 3 systems lined up. And unfortunately, we're going to continue to see more rain, more wind for the Pacific Northwest. But the good news is you need it because you've got a little bit of drought there right in the West, I think. The Northwest.
Finding the bright side. I like it.
Right, right. The Northwest is looking pretty good there. But take a look at all the moisture that's going to be streaming up here along the coast, and even moving inland as we go into the next couple of days. You're going to see a lot through here. Pretty much rain all day Saturday and into Sunday. Also some winds 40 to 50 miles per hour.
I heard the buzzer. Get on out. Let's bring in storm specialist Carl Parker talking about the unseasonable warmth that's moving in. Carl, 30 seconds for you.
There are a lot of people who really love cold.
Yeah.
Believe it or not.
It's not me.
Not me necessarily, but a lot of people really do look forward to the winter, and all the really cold air is way up in northern parts of North America, far northern Canada, and Alaska as well, and then we'll take a look at temperatures a little farther south, and it really is pretty mild across a lot of the southern tier of Canada and the northern tier of the U.S., and that is the way it's going to be for a while. We're going to talk much more about temperatures coming right up.
Yeah, in fact, I want a little bit more. I want more. Let's go into overtime on Carl's topic, because so many people have been noticing this difference, this setup has been so big time different from what we've seen maybe the past couple of winters, and certainly the past couple of weeks we had a shot of cold air. Carl, any chance that we'll get more cold? What's the setup here?
Well, yeah, no, I think there's a lot of chance that we're going to get more cold, because you get a lot of variability, generally speaking, though we didn't see a whole lot of variability in the last couple of years. We had the big red setup on the West Coast,
yeah,
and that was it. That was all that we saw for the most part. But, you know, the one thing that's happening now is we're seeing a pattern that's a lot like some of the stronger El Nino cases, which is not to say that it happens like this all the time with El Nino. It doesn't. There's a lot of variability within El Ninos, but we are seeing this big warm up across the middle of the country, and that is something that's more typical of some of the stronger cases. We don't have a real big sample size, but when you look at the two strongest cases of El Ninos, it looks a lot like that, with a lot of warming across the northern tier of the country.
And so we're talking temperatures across the northern tier that are the biggest departure from their normals.
Yeah.
But 20 degrees above average, 50 degrees in international
National Falls.
Yeah.
It's hard to talk snow.
Shorts weather.
Yeah.
I mean, it's going to be really, really mild. If you like that kind of thing, if you wanted to get out and do a little more golf, it's going to be beautiful across a lot of the Northern Plains going into the early part of next week. 55 degrees there in North Platte. And what we're looking at here are the temperature departures. So temperatures relative to average, very, very warm across the northern tier. And that's going to go on right through the next couple of weeks. This is the model forecast going out into the later part of December. And we don't see a whole lot of change. And again, this has got El Nino written all over it. And not a big surprise, because we have actually had, when you look at it on a weekly basis, the strongest El Nino ever recorded. Now, officially, that'll be the case if it's a three-month average. That's the highest. But on a weekly basis, 3.1 degrees above the average. That's huge.
In record territory, we'll see if that continues to make it an overall record El Nino.
Exactly.
All right. And now we want to take a bit of a tour. A tour of the country from east to west on the tower cams. Miami not looking too shabby at all, although the rain is still nearby. It was a very rainy day for you. Had record-breaking rains the past 2 days, and now we've got even more rain that's knocking on the doorstep. A couple more inches can't be ruled out. How about Minneapolis? High temperatures into the 40s into next week. Those southerly winds are taking over. They are really going to be ramping up across the next several days. Plus, we've got this one. How about Old Faithful? Yellowstone National Park has been seeing a little bit of active weather, right? You might have some snow to start off next week. Nah, temperatures at or below freezing, so if you want the snow, if you want the cold, that's where you got to go. And finally, we're looking at San Francisco. The bridge there, right? Not a bad view. A chance for showers over the weekend. We do need the rain still to get a little bit further south. People are like, we've got all these storms coming into the Pacific Northwest, Alex. What about Southern California? What about the rest of the West? You see anything on the horizon there?
It's going to be a tough go for places south of south of San Francisco, really south of Seattle. That's the jackpot going to be right around the Seattle area, ports of western Washington, and then lesser totals the further south that you go. Right now, notice cloud-free across parts of Southern California. There's the next system that's going to work into the Northwest, offering up the wind, the rain, the snow, the mix of both. So we've got plenty headed our way, and then into next week, yet another storm system. We're calling it a parade of storms. It's not the kind of parade maybe you want to be a part of, at least if you're tired of the rain or you've got some outdoor stuff you've got to do. Rain and wind this weekend. Notice that moisture stream right into parts of the Northwest. We're going to keep that feed of moisture into the Northwest even into early next week. So more of the same, more rain, more wind, more snow. More of it all. Tomorrow's forecast, rain closer to the coast in Washington and Oregon, snow off to the east. Now, here's some good news. This part of Oregon, and also getting into this part of Washington and Oregon, you guys are under drought. It's this part of Washington that doesn't have any drought, and that's where the highest totals are going to be. Here's your drought monitor, exceptional drought off to the south. Notice those areas looking at nothing or up to an inch. That's as good as it gets. Where there's no drought, 8 to 12 inches possible. Seattle's forecast looks like this. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, rain. There you go. You can just record this today and watch this every day, and you'll know what's coming, at least until middle of next week. Guys.
I don't think you want to encourage people to do that. I'm just saying.
I feel like I have really good hair today. Yeah. I have really good hair today.
You do.
Though.
We're gonna take a snapshot.
But you have good hair every day. Tune back in Monday to see just how good it gets by then.
Your hair looks good today too, Mark.
I went to a special barber for it.
Let's talk about your video six pack. We're talking the best videos from the entire week. We start with Russia and the Ukraine struggling with big snow and deadly cold there. Heavy snow closed some roads, stranded some people. Obviously used to dealing with snow, but even for them a lot. Unfortunately killed 37 people in the Ukraine in recent weeks. So everything has an action reaction in the atmosphere. Warm in the east, United States, but cold there. All right, number five, not just a thunderstorm here in Miami, but look at the lightning. So this person shakes a little bit with the camera when it hits, which I understand. Wait for it. Wait for it some more. Still wait for it.
There it goes.
This is a tease. This is what I don't know. Maybe it's not going to happen. It happened in the previous video. Anyways, there's a lightning strike that happens at some point. Hey! Yes! I'm going to be like George Costanza. I'm out. That's it. I'm done. All right, let's move on. That one took a long time. Number four, more lightning. This one happens a little more timely fashion. This is in Australia. Bam, right there into a street light on the side of the road there. So that was very, very close to them. And we're going to actually keep it in Australia. That was pretty cool. I wish they'd turned the phone the other way. Let's go to number three in Australia. This is last night's winner, Dust Devil, a music festival in Victoria, Australia. Earlier this week, So, you know, festival goers, you do enough drugs, you're gonna like anything. So that's pretty much what we got going on here. But you know what? They're into it, they're enjoying it. Not normally a great thing to run into because it can toss things around, but you're better off running into one of those than you would be a water spout. By the way, it's spinning in opposite direction of what you'd expect in the Southern Hemisphere. So that's kind of interesting. Mark, you wanna come in?
I do, because I know that we've been voting and getting everybody's thoughts on the number two or number one videos. Right. Everyone's kind of battling it out. They're both pretty good.
So earlier in the week, we were putting these ridiculous. We did puppy versus smog at one point.
And no chance. Puppy's going to win.
I'm like, yeah, it's just not fair. So let's see what we got here. What are the results, Ryan?
Boom. Oh,
ouch. Oh, no. What do we do? Is there chads, hanging chads we can look at?
I think I'm gonna take the executive decision and say that puppy's now number two.
You're gonna pick against a puppy?
Is that, yeah? I'm gonna
go. We saw the puppy a lot.
We saw the puppy all week.
Puppies do number two a lot.
Yeah, sure. I think we have a lot to say about the plane.
Okay, so here's a husky going down. I mean, this is so cute.
It is.
Why are you such a bad person, Mark?
I'm just saying. It's a husky. Yeah. He's got to know how to deal with ice. Now's his time to learn.
He should actually know how to deal with
ice. You should be better at this, young pup.
Let's go to the plane. I will admit that the plane, that was, by the way, in Topeka. The plane is really cool. This is Manchester, England.
What
it's amazing about this is the aborted landing at the end. You see some shaky landings, but they decided they were making too much of a tilt, so...
Do they floor it and just
they get
go
out
back
of there.
In?
Wait for it.
Oh, boy. Nope.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
That's amazing.
I know how to give you the hairstyle more like mine to put you on a flight like that, and you won't have any hair left by the end of that one.
I'm a pretty confident flyer, but that would wear me out.
If you're going in for a landing and all of a sudden you're taking off again?
Yeah.
No, thanks. Yeah. Speaking of extremes, how about extreme weather on this day in the past? Like this, ice thick enough to cause trees to bend and break. When and where that ice snapped power poles to more than a million people, left some in the dark for more than a week. And right now, we want to talk to you. We're going on Periscope during the break. Go to Weather Underground's Twitter page. You can join in on the conversation.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment. I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It's the one and only cure that's one pill once a day for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. With Harvoni, there's no interferon, and there are no complex regimens. Tell your doctor if you have other liver or kidney problems or other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Harvoni should not be taken with any medicines containing amiodarone, rifampin, or St. John's wort. It also should not be taken with any other medicine that contains Sovaldi. Side effects may include tiredness and headache.
I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
Brought to you by Harvoni. Are you ready?
Coughing, sniffling, and wishing you could stay in bed all day. When your cold is this bad, you need new Theraflu Express Max. Theraflu Express Max combines maximum strength medicines available without a prescription to fight your worst cold and flu symptoms, so you can feel better fast and get back to the job at hand. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy, meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
The holidays bring many challenges to the feet. By day, they must stay warm, but by night, beautiful, smoother, and ready to impress the other party animals. Dr. Scholl's Dreamwalk Express Petty.
The challenges facing the country never stop. So neither does the U.S. Army. We train, adapt, and get smarter. Every soldier, every unit, every day. not to keep up with change, but to drive it. Nobody knows what problems tomorrow will bring, but we do know who will solve them.
Intel's best processor is here, and it helps PCs wake up instantly, just like you did.
That's great, but do you mind?
No, I don't mind.
Introducing Intel's new 6th generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
What's this?
A box. It takes worn out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn-out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
This day in weather history, December 4th, 2002. A major ice storm spans from Oklahoma to the Carolinas. It causes the largest power outage ever in North Carolina, with more than 1.7 million people left in the dark. 8 days later, more than 40,000 were still without electricity.
Unbelievable that just a huge ice storm and potentially some impacts from ice storm this year. So we're bringing in winter weather expert Tom Nizel to talk more about the perspective from that storm and maybe even lead us forward for this year.
Yeah, that was, went back and looked at the weather pattern for that storm. That was a classic setup for an ice storm. You had an Arctic outbreak that came down out of Canada and you had this really strong southern jet stream. That combined with the moisture that this system brought up from the Gulf produced those types of power outages and catastrophic, absolutely.
Yeah, the worst power outages that North Carolina has ever experienced, even to this date. So, I mean, we're you know, several more years of experience since then, and that one's still the record holder.
Well, in a classic long-lived storm, because it extended all the way from the Oklahoma right out to the coast of the Carolinas. So it really put down a path of destruction.
So we know this year we've got the active subtropical jet part of things.
Yeah.
Are we going to have the rest of the ingredients that come into play to get the cold air?
Well, that's it. You need two ingredients. You need the moisture and you need the cold air and you need that setup. And, you know, we've got half of it. So we've talked about this several times, that it's not entirely out of the question in an El Nino type of year that you could get a pattern that sets up once or twice during the winter to produce really destructive ice storms.
All right. So, I mean, what is it about the El Nino year that would make you think about ice storms as being one of the more impactful winter weather events?
Well, again, the typical ice storm has some type of low pressure system moving along in the southern jet stream across the southeastern United States. And then the second ingredient there is going to be the cold air that comes down out of the north. And so we're going to have to watch for that. We've already had an event that was pretty close to that. Oklahoma, just a week and a half ago, there was catastrophic ice damage across there in parts of the panhandle of Texas.
All right. So that is, we've already seen it, is your point. So we could certainly have another one, maybe further south, further east. I mean, winter's honestly just getting going. In your past few years of naming storms, it's been December where the storm numbers have really ramped up.
They do ramp up. And we've seen several ice events that have occurred after we get after the first of the year. You may remember one here in Atlanta a couple of years ago.
I do indeed. Remember it well. So let's talk more about this. What impact can El Nino have on the number and locations of ice storms? Let's go over to our maps here into the Pixel and really talk about this, because the El Nino pattern's coming into play. How do we kind of break down the big scale pattern with the smaller scale weather changes that we could see?
Yeah, and again, the El Nino pattern is representative by a very active subtropical jet stream. And it's generally cooler and wetter here. The coolness often associated with just the storm in us is here. So that's part one. Part two is what comes from the northern stream. Now, in the big ice storm that occurred in 2002, notice where the jet is. Instead of being up here in our El Nino pattern, it's taken this dip, and there's your subtropical jet. In this setup, what you had was a low pressure system that developed out here across the southern plains, and it just worked all along this Arctic boundary here. And I think we can move that forward to show how that sets up right here.
I mean, it was perfect. You had everything you needed, the moisture from the southern branch, but the cold air from the north. And that low kind of rode the boundary.
It did. Now, back a week and a half ago, we had a 1045 high that came down out of Canada and drove a blue norther all the way down into southern Texas, that cold front. We ran a little low pressure system along here and it came up into the central plains, produced a lot of ice there. So what we need is we need another cold air outbreak. The southern stream is going to be active, no doubt. The northern stream can buckle at times. And if it buckles in the right place at the right time, then you set up the potential for some type of large-scale ice event from the south through the southeastern U.S.
There are some hints that this could be difficult this year, though. I mean, just this past week, we were looking at New England. You had a front going through. You had rain. You had a high-pressure zone off the coast. And yet, it was way too warm for snow or ice.
Yeah, you're right.
So if that trend continues, we're not going to see as much winter weather.
You could easily go through the whole winter without seeing that cold air making it down here when you have some type of weather system tracking along here. So we'll just have to see.
So this cold air, well, it gets blamed for a lot of different things, including collisions, cars not starting. That's something that we're blamed for as well. But here's the thing. Cold, blamed for more than that, maybe for getting you sick.
Ooh.
Does the weather actually make you ill? We're going to talk about that coming up. Is under the weather really a thing?
You got the dough?
Trying to get there.
All right, and you're washing the greens, right?
These collard greens look great.
Hey.
This year, it's my time to add my flavor to the tradition. Then at long last comes the best part. Honoring those who raised us.
Low prices on everything you need to share wonder every day. Walmart.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
Where's the rain that's happening right now as you walk out the door?
A lot of people traveling, but we'll keep an eye on it for you.
Because the weather impacts your day in 100 ways you see and 1,000 ways you don't.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
So include us in your routine.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 72 degrees with light rain. Tonight, rain, low 71. Winds northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Rainfall around a half an inch. Saturday, cloudy with occasional rain showers. High 79. Chance of rain, 80%. Saturday night, variable clouds with showers and scattered thunderstorms. Low 74. Chance of rain, 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
If you have moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis like me, and you're talking to your rheumatologist about a biologic, this is Humira. This is Humira helping to relieve my pain and protect my joints from further damage. This is Humira giving me new perspective. Doctors have been prescribing Humira for 10 years. Humira works for many adults. It targets and helps to block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to RA symptoms.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections, or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Talk to your doctor and visit Humira.com. This is Humira at Work.
It's the final countdown. The final countdown.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to GEICO.
What can happen when your homeowner association switches your technology provider?
They're all sorry that they switched over.
I was disappointed when they hooked us up.
Phone is no longer available.
And the TV goes out.
You will be on hold for about an hour to 2 hours. This is normal.
Certainly a little bit more costly.
I never had the issues with Comcast.
Oh, I wish we still had Comcast.
Redemption Song Rescue League is proud to present our first annual benefit concert with a night of Nashville in the Round featuring John Ford Coley and Cherie Austin up close and personal Friday, December 4th at 7 p.m. at the Plaza Ballroom and Event Center. Seating is available at thersrl.org. For more information, contact 615-974-0225. Don't miss this night of Nashville in the Round with John Ford Coley and Cherie Austin right here in North Palm Beach. All proceeds to benefit Redemption Song Rescue League.
Subs, founded by firemen.
Monday on AMHQ, will Florida's weekend storms continue into your work week? Plus, will the warmer than average temperatures wreck your chance for a white Christmas? That's Monday at 5 a.m. on AMHQ. All right, welcome back to Weather Underground. We are looking at not the current conditions. Stand by. Wait for it. There was a devastating ice storm back then, but that was over 10 years ago. So let's talk about what's going on right now. Maybe you're getting all dolled up for your Friday night plans. You're ready to get out there. You don't need an umbrella unless you're in South Florida or out into parts of the West, out into western Washington, Oregon. That's where we've got rain showers, and that's where a lot of the action's going to be as we head into the weekend. National forecast tomorrow, rain for Seattle, high elevation snow. Also a mix in some spots. L.A., you are dry. Dallas, you are dry. Chicago, near 50, partly cloudy. Looks good there. New York, 51. Miami, South Florida, that's where the rain showers are going to be all the way through the weekend. And your Sunday forecast, I said Miami's the place where your rain showers are going to be. That's where they are. And Chicago, you've got some showers in the neighborhood, but I think you'll stay dry for the second half of the weekend. I'm in a big girl chair now. This is great.
Alex just beeline for the recliner and kick Keith out of it. So I like the twinsies thing happening down there.
We're twins anyways.
Yeah. Alex is going to be comfy. The girls in pink are in the chairs. Guys, lots of comments coming in today throughout the show. So a busy sounding off segment. Let's get right on into it. Here is the first question coming in from Calamity Ted. Ominous name. Have any climate models indicated travel past a climate tipping point? Are we too far in?
Well, you know, a certain amount of warming is going to be baked in no matter what at this point. So we're going to get to a certain point no matter what. But as far as tipping points are concerned, I don't think we've gotten to that point yet, but there have been some very interesting papers on that. There's one that talks about the Younger Dryas period, and that was something that happened a long time ago when we were coming out of an ice age where we actually got a lot colder across the Northern Hemisphere because of the slowdown of the global ocean conveyor belt. And that is beginning to happen right now, and that can actually cool things off across a lot of the Northern Hemisphere in Europe in the space of a few decades. So there is concern that there could be this kind of thing in the not too distant future.
And that's a big shift when something like that happens. All right, next question coming in on your sounding off segment. This one from Mindy saying, okay, weather question. Why was it so foggy all day in South Central Ohio today? It never burned off or lifted off. Cold, windy, and foggy. Ugh.
Probably, if I read it right, we had a pretty good low-level inversion, a trapping of the air on the backside of the cold front going through. And when you have that, it doesn't allow the air to mix out all that much. And so I think we kept that moisture locked in there, kept them fogged down.
Although windy and foggy are not often something you
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
that's
right. Usually your calmer winds.
Yeah. It's pretty still or it just moves out. Yeah. But that's probably the cause of the trap there.
Needed
yeah.
enough warm air to break through that low level. Right. And if you didn't get it, you were stuck in the low clouds all day. All right, we always learn a lot on this show, so let's start off with what we learned today. I learned that Miami has almost matched its entire winter rainfall precipitation total in just the past 3 days. And there's still a lot more rain to come.
You just took everyone else's answer.
Sorry.
I learned, I guess, reiterated the fact that the Euro continues to lead the pack. You know, we're looking at that coastal low, and again, the GFS blinks to it. From the American standpoint of things, like, we need to get another space war going here and get more competitive with it. You know I'm a Euro hugger, but again, the Euro.
Great model.
Yeah.
You know, I learned that there's been a real increase in ice storms in just the last couple of decades. There was a paper that came out about this, and they're not sure whether or not it's because of warm or if it's because of reporting. It may just be that there are more people reporting ice storms across
like the
Central Plains.
Kind of like the low-level tornadoes.
Yes, exactly. But there has been an increase, at least statistically speaking.
Good stuff. Ryan.
I learned today that it is very likely that you're not going to see a white Christmas if you live anywhere east of the Rockies.
Womp womp.
That's tragic. Hmm.
Yeah, what I learned reinforced me myself with the fact about the drought in the Pacific Northwest. You get on the other side, there's the windward side or the leeward side of the Cascades, and still very significant drought conditions there. So hopefully, bout upon bout of this heavy rain is going to help them.
Hmm. Technically, a desert there, and so hard to make up the deficit once you do get into dry conditions. Mm-hmm.
Sarah. Yeah, and I guess mine kind of extends to what Tom was saying, you know, about how much, well, you know, we were looking at the drought monitor and how it looked very red in northwestern Washington. Now it's not, but the reservoir's really kind of built up over the last couple of events that they've had. But, you know, like you were saying, it's only been about two weeks since they had a significant storm. So, you know, with them having those back-to-back, you know, maybe that's a little bit unusual for them. Maybe it's not, but, you know, it's just something to watch.
But isn't it encouraging that we're getting so much weather in the
yes,
last?
Yes, it
you
is.
Know, it just feels good. Like, we're finally seeing
some troughiness in the West. Yeah. We haven't talked about that, yeah. I feel like, in 3 years. So yeah. It's nice to kind of talk it about is. That yeah. again.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And Alex?
I learned if you sit in this chair, everybody else says you're what you learned. Yeah. So yeah. I'm going to actually go take right. that chair next time.
Would you get? Yeah.
More recently than anything, I learned that right behind Carl, nobody likes anything else in the trail mix but the M&Ms.
Really?
Oh. Meteorologists do not. There is no M&Ms in that trail mix. It is just peanuts and raisins.
I eat the almonds. I don't eat the peanuts.
Don't you eat trail mix without it? Because that's
it's
just
always about the snacks.
Yeah. I just don't
it's
like the peanuts.
It's always about the snacks.
But no, the white Christmas possibility, I think, for a lot of people, it's kind of
probably
a bummer when you look. Yeah, I mean.
Yeah. All right. Well, on that optimistic
really
note, it is time now for open mic. And as is the tradition here, when I step in, I'm starting this off with a question mark. So, how you feeling today? I'm willing to bet that many of you are struggling with some sort of cough or cold or flu or ailment right now, and that the weather is being blamed for causing it. Hey, we've all heard it, right? It's cold out. Put on your hat and your jacket or you're going to catch a cold. False. Cold air doesn't cause sickness, viruses do. Although, in full disclosure, the dry air that comes with that cold can make it easier for a virus to get in through the nasal passages, but it has nothing to do with the cold itself. Or how about, I get sick every time the seasons change? Well, you might, but it's not because of the calendar changing or the weather that comes with it. It's because you are hanging out with people at those times. Your nephew that never washes his hands on Thanksgiving, you're double dipping in the appetizer friends in New Year's, or maybe your never covers his mouth cousin at Easter. You may still be feeling a bit under the weather, and even this has very little to do with weather itself. It's actually an old sailor's term. If you were sick, you went down to your sleeping quarters, which were often under the weather observation deck and away from all the cold and wet waves and wind. And as such, the sailor was under the weather. How about that? You can use the weekend to rest up. You can go to wonderground.com/blog and feel better while reading the latest from Jeff Masters about the lack of tornadoes in 2015 and the potential lowest death toll from those tornadoes ever on record. That'll make anyone feel good. And for all of us here at Weather Underground, thanks for watching. Have a great night. And remember, together, we know more. Mike Bettis, back on Monday.
All the time.
Was that actually your cousin?
No.
1 city explodes. A mountain crumbles. And one of the widest tornadoes in American history comes roaring across the heartland.
No, turn now!
From nightmare typhoons to record-setting volcanoes, things are about to get nasty. We'll light you up and blow you away. So roll up the windows, lock down the doors, and get ready to ride out the storm. It's all ahead on Weather Caught on Camera.
Kind of panic.
Every storm hunter knows sometimes you chase the tornado and sometimes it chases you.
No, turn now! Come down! Fred, if you don't go down, we're gonna die!
It's May 31st, 2013. And just northwest of Union City, Oklahoma, the clouds are gathering in the area known as Tornado Alley. A massive storm appears on the horizon. Everyone else heads away, but not storm chasers Brandon Sullivan and Brett Wright. Driver Brett Wright is a descendant of the original Wright brothers, but even they never saw skies like this.
We really had no idea that the whole sky basically was the tornado. It was
just absolutely huge.
Mini tornadoes were forming everywhere.
2 miles of the sky above us is churning violently.
Big tornado on the ground. Large multi-vortex. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Get in the car, get ready to drive, Brett. Large tornado.
You're just looking at a black wall like it's nighttime.
And we noticed the tornado was coming at us and it was getting closer by the second.
I started to get this sense kind of down deep in my stomach that maybe we were in trouble and a little bit over our heads and we should probably get out of there.
Brett, we got 30 seconds. Oh my goodness. Brett, turn the car around. Let's get ready.
Woo! Go, go, get the tripod. Just drive. Just drive.
But now the tornado changes direction.
I see that it's actually turned right and it's coming at us even as we drive south.
The headwinds start building up to 100 miles an hour.
The winds were pushing me off the road, so I was driving straight by turning right.
The tornado's heading right at them, and it's coming fast.
We were in big trouble. I knew we were way too close to the tornado at that point. That's when I began to get really scared. Yes!
Go, Brad, go! Wedge! Fast as you can!
It rips apart a farm, and the debris comes flying. First, the sheet metal.
Yeah! Get down! Duck down! Duck down!
Sheet metal, and it hit the windshield and shattered it right into my lap.
And then a 2,000-pound hay bale hits them dead on.
Oh, just drive.
It's like driving down the highway in traffic blindfolded. You don't really know what's going on.
Our car actually begins to feel like it's about to roll over. I can feel my side coming off the ground.
I knew if we got immobilized that we'd be in big trouble.
We gotta get to safety. We're down. They're fine. We're fine. We're fine.
Tried not to panic, because if I knew if I panicked, I might have gone off the road, you know, or lost control, and that would have been bad.
Brian, I can't see. I can't see where I'm going. Oh, my God. Yeah, my car's totaled. Just drive. Yeah.
It crossed my mind many times that this could be the end. I could go out chasing a tornado.
In the end, it's a close call for these two University of Oklahoma students as the storm turns away.
The tornado was obviously huge. You know, it was found to be 2.6 miles wide, which is one of the largest in U.S. history.
Not everyone will make it safely through this day. The storm will claim the lives of three veteran storm chasers.
I've chased quite a few times since the tornado, and I don't get as close. You know, losing valued storm chasers, brilliant people like that, it makes you take a step back.
I can't see. Okay, that's fine.
I hopefully never experience something as scary, but if I do, I'll be ready for it.
Get down! Duck down! Duck down!
It really gives you a sense of just how powerful things on this planet can be.